order, everyone. I'm going to call the meeting to order. Welcome, bienvenidos a todos. Welcome to all of you. I'm gonna do the Pledge of Allegiance. And Georgia, you want to give the pledge? Actually, I was born and raised in Arizona where there's a lot of cactus, so I like cactus.
Agenda 1.5, we will have the elections of officers of the board. And so I'm going to read the bylaws real quick of our board. The board shall each year elect one of its members to be president following this process. Board president will carry on any and all board members who wish to be picked and ask for a brief statement. Board president will then ask for nominations for board president. Nominations will be voted in the order they were voiced. The nomination that is approved by the majority of the board causes any remaining nominations to fail. So first off, I will be asking who would like to be president. I would ask a brief statement for them. Bye.
I wonder if I should go for president again, because this might be my last year and I've only been president once, because I'm going to be on this board 16 years.
Long time.
But I don't know. We did elect Ria de Hart 2 years when I was on the board. We elected her twice. So. I guess I could, but I'm willing to have any other person get elected too.
I would also like to ask for my nomination for president of the Pajaro Valley Unified School District. Alone in my first year, I worked with Dr. Superintendent Dr. Rodriguez and CBO Joe Dominguez to get rid of the amount of dirt that has been in EO Hall for years. I worked with Dr. Michelle Rodriguez and CBO Joe to finally complete the field at EO Hall, which was supposed to be there in 2012. I worked with PVUSD staff to finally get Mini White School their new portables, which they were supposed to get in 2012. I have met with PVPI students, along with other trustees, on ordinance to ban vaping, and I also have attended many city council meetings to work together to get these things passed. I worked with past Mayor Francisco Estrada to create Ray the Heart Day for the city of Washington. I've worked with Councilmember Aurelio Gonzalez to fight against a nonprofit that wanted to bring needles and hand them out at Celebration Army and Grant Street, and I fought against that because you're trying to put a free needle exchange by Watsawa High. I spoke in favor of renewing Measure G, which is now Measure Y, because I believe we need our police and firefighters, and also a percentage of those funds would be going to our parks.
And youth.
Yes, thank you. And finally, within my first 6 months of being trustee, thank you to Dr. Rodriguez for allowing me to bring a program that should give free eye examinations to children to consider at low performing schools. So I'm kind of nervous, but I would like the support of my board, and I hope they can count on your vote. Thank you.
Well, I mean, you don't have to vote for me, but I also, I'm involved in, I'm on four committees. He's not on any. He's not on any committee. I'm on four committees. I go to lots and lots of meetings every month, and I go to every single school function that I can go to. I try to go to all the school functions if I can. And I've worked for safe streets, and obviously I was at the meeting in EA Hall about the track, to support the track, and I've been at city council meetings as well, but I'm okay with Danny too.
Thank you very much, Karen. Is there a motion and a second?
Anybody else want to consider it?
I'd like to make a motion to move for Vice Chair Trustee Daniel Dodge Jr. to be moved as President of the Board.
Second.
Can I get a roll call vote?
Trustee Shocker, your vote?
I vote for Danny Dodge.
Trustee Orozco, your vote?
Yes, in support of Daniel Dodge.
Trustee DeCerco, your vote?
Aye.
Trustee Holm?
Aye.
Trustee Acosta?
Aye, in support of Daniel Dodge Jr.
Trustee Dodge?
Yes.
President Osmondson?
Yeah.
Okay. So the book, nomination vote carries.
Thank you very much, everybody. So in a separate action, the board shall then elect one of its members to be vice president / clerk following this process. Board president will call on any and all board members who wish to be vice president clerk and ask for a brief statement. Board president will then ask for nominations for board vice president clerk. Nominations will be voted in the order they were voiced. The first nomination that is approved by the majority of the board causes any remaining nominations to fail. I will now ask any of my board members who wish to be vice president / clerk.
I am interested. Would you like me to give a statement now or after? Okay. It's been an honor to serve, you know, on the Board of Trustees. I would like to serve in this additional capacity and responsibility. I feel that I have a good working relationship with all of you, and I'd like to continue that communication and help us develop a collaborative board.
Thank you. So I make a nomination to
Okay.
like to put myself in for vice president. I have enjoyed my first year on the board. I've been very involved with our community, attending numerous community events, working with the city on various programs, working with PDPSA with the vaping issue, going to different health committee meetings at our district for a healthier food choices for our students, working with after-school programs to get some more free after-school programs brought into our district. I can go on and on, but I'm not going to. We've all been very active, and I'd like to continue to be active. And I thank all of you for your support to me as a new oncoming board member this past year.
Any other nominations? I'd like to make a motion to support Jennifer Satcher as vice president. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
So we have a first and a second. Can I get a roll call vote?
Trustee DeSerpa, your vote?
No.
Trustee Holm, your vote?
No, good one.
Trustee Shocker, your vote?
Yes.
Trustee Orozco?
No.
Trustee Acosta?
Yes.
Trustee Dodge?
Yes.
Trustee Osmondson?
President Osmondson? I'll
say
no
again.
All right?
Yes. No.
No?
Yeah.
I guess.
Motion fails. So we have. Go ahead and take a roll call vote now.
Trustee Acosta, your vote?
Aye.
Trustee Shocker, your vote?
Aye.
Trustee Orozco, your vote?
Aye.
Trustee Holm, your vote?
Aye.
Trustee Serpa, your vote?
Aye.
President Dodd?
Yes.
Trustee Osmondson?
Yes.
Thank you very much. All right, we're going to take a quick break and we have time. Don't go on the break.
Thank you.
2020 board meeting schedule. Michelle.
Yes. So thank you very much. So what you will find is the proposed 2020 board session. If you look at the attachment, what you will see is, as customary, we have only one board meeting in January. We traditionally do not do it the second or fourth, as we usually do, because of the holiday. So we have a 3-week break. Most of us, especially at the district office, do not take all 3 weeks, but some staff does. So this allows staff to not have to work through the break. February, March, April is fairly normal. In April, we usually just have one board meeting. So during that time, we have in the past 2 years done a special board study session on our academic data so that the board could go do a deep dive into data. So that is continues to be my recommendation in April, which would cause us to continue to have two board meetings in April. You'll see it continue on. What you'll notice in the bullets is just some of the large items. Such as third interim budget adoption. July, we have one board meeting. August, we traditionally have one regular board meeting, one closed session special board meeting, which is my evaluation. We always do that the second week in August. And then you see the rest. November is requested to be the 18th because of the Thanksgiving holiday. And we again will have to have, just a note, the annual organizational meeting will have to occur on the December 16th. Again, we have to do the first interim budget prior to December 15th, but we can't do the, we cannot do the organizational meeting until after the second Friday, which is why we have to do it on the 16th. And so this is staff's recommendation for the board meeting schedule.
Any discussion from the board?
I have a couple of questions. So I had the understanding that in April, we were going to start doing, because we used to do in the past the students' awards and recognitions at various board meetings throughout the year, and then we said we were going to have one special meeting in April, I think was the target to do that, where that was just for that night, for that recognition. Is that, I take it, is not this special study K-12 academic data session, correct?
So we were going to tag the two together, and it should have been noted that. So the goal would be to do the, So it would be an addition. So what we would do is something very similar to what we're doing tonight, is that we would do the student recognition, and then we would go into the special board study session, just because the special board study sessions are generally shorter. So it would allow us to still do like a 6 to 9.
Okay, and so we could do add that students first, of course.
Of course.
Okay.
Students would go first.
And then going into the December meeting, so I did read up on the AB 2449, and it's kind of unfortunate that that law was put in, because it really contradicts the state election code law, which says that for all 58 counties in the state of California, all election clerks have to have those races certified by that first Friday. And we have even written into our board policy about when the transition actually does technically take place between newly elected board members and outgoing board members. But nonetheless, it is a law for now, unless someone has a sense to repeal it. So since we are having two board meetings in December, would it be possible, just for ceremonial purposes, and I believe we've had this conversation before, that at the December 9th meeting, if we have board members that will be going out, and we will know because the elections will be certified by that Friday before, could we have the ceremonial going out of outgoing board members on December 9th, and then on December 16th recognize that have the new incoming ones, so it's two separate events, because last year it lasted far too long, for one, and two, it's, I mean, when you have a transition of power like that, it's uncomfortable for both the outgoing trustee and the incoming, depending upon the dynamics. So could we consider that or implement that now? That, and I'm just speaking, I'm not speaking about who actually has the power, but just for the ceremonial purposes.
I will say, if it legally is possible, it sounds like a really great idea. I just would want to talk with legal counsel just because the new law just came into effect, and so I don't know all the nuances of it. As long as the new law doesn't prohibit it, then that sounds, I know it's been a challenge in the past, so I think that would be a great suggestion.
Yeah, and I'm really just speaking more to our ceremonial component of it, where we recognize outgoing board members, and then of course recognize the incoming board members. So.
I just want to let you guys know that I will not be in town on February
26th.
Just letting you know, are you giving? June 24th. Well, because I don't want, if there's other board members gone, I want to make sure that we have a quorum so that that date's a problem.
To let Michelle and your board president know, like closer to the date, just so sometimes there's things that are in the action items that are really important.
I know now, because we'll be, hopefully my sister-in-law will be having her baby.
Any other discussion from the board? Can I go ahead and get a motion?
Also move to approve the Board of Trustees meeting schedule for the 2020 calendar year.
I'll second that motion.
Can I go ahead and get a roll call vote?
No.
I will call for a vote. All in favor?
No, he said call for vote.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Next item on the agenda, 1.9, coordinate board representation to district and community committees, report by Dr. Michelle Rodriguez.
Thank you. So we were able to provide you the information this past week. Hopefully you found that helpful so that you had the dates a little bit earlier. We know that in some cases we were not able to get all the dates, and we will work with our various organizations to try to have that in the future. But Eva tried 2 weeks out and we're not able to provide all of the dates. But what we do is we have 13 of them. As you know, we cannot have more than three on each one. The agenda setting generally is a little bit different in that generally, and I think anything could change, but generally it is the president, the vice president, and then it's a third person. We try to do it geographically different. In this case, we have two already geographically diverse people. It would be discussion and the will of both the president and vice president of who they would like that third person to be, or they can open it up for a request.
I just wanted to comment to that, Michelle. I mean, in the past, it's always usually been the outgoing board president that has also sort of by default served with the president and the current president and current vice chair. This last year, we had a different circumstance where Maria Rosco stepped up to do it because our previous president was elected out of office and she was the vice chair, so she stepped up and took that seat. So
that's not accurate, Georgia.
That is how it was in the has been in the past, and that was definitely how it was the first 2 years I was on the board.
I don't remember, like, after I was the board president, I never was on the, I was twice, and I was never on the agenda committee the following year, just FYI. Maybe that's been the practice, but I think it was sort of de facto. I don't think that it happened that way on purpose. So anyway, it could be really anybody on the board.
So, since I've been, it's the other way.
Oh, there it goes.
since I've already been pretty active in board stuff, I wouldn't mind, I mean, unless somebody else wants to do it, being on the agenda committee since I've been already, you know, working on a lot of agendas.
Just to be fair, can I ask if there's anybody else interested?
Yeah, is there anybody else interested?
I would be.
I think that having former president Trustee Osmundson on there, as you were even speaking to, if you know, just certainly wants to challenge me on this, and maybe by, you know, she decided to not be when she was the former president. But that was past practice. But nonetheless, if you were speaking, Michelle, to demographics, we've definitely got the northern zone represented. We've got the southern Watsonville zone represented. And Trustee Osmundson represents some of the most vulnerable students in our district in Monterey County. We have no other trustee that resides in Monterey County.
That's true.
I mean, Trustee Acosta is correct. Karen is the only trustee in Monterey County that would support that alone, this one.
All right, so we will have those three be on the agenda setting. So for the rest of them, 12 through 13, what we have done in the past is we have asked the board to provide us their requests, which ones that they would like to. And then we, if needed, we've had discussions if we've had four or more, because we can only have three on each one. So we don't have to go necessarily in order from 2 to 13 if you would prefer. You can tell me which ones. I can start listing them down. And then if we have a conflict, then there can be a conversation.
Can we start off at the end of the table? Trustee, one by one?
Yes.
That way.
Which one would you like to start with first?
Mr. Costa, would you please name?
Sure. I would like to be appointed to the Adult Education Advisory Committee and the CTE Advisory Committee.
Okay. I would like to be on the Intergovernmental Committee, the Safety Committee, and the Arts Education Committee, as well as the Adult Education Committee.
I've been on the same committee for 15 years, so I'm going to continue to be on my same committees, which is DLAC, Migrant, Seasonal Head Start. I want to try to do better on the special education, but I also go to a committee that's not really listed as a committee. It's the Migrant Parent Advisory Committee, which is not listed as a committee, but I try to go to those meetings as well. That's another meeting that I go to, but I guess it's not listed as a committee. I wouldn't mind being on the intergovernmental, because I've never been on it before. But, you know, if there's too many people on it, you know, I'm fine with that, not being on it. But, so, I've never been on that one before. It would be fun to go on.
I serve on PDPSA, SELPA Committee, Spectre Arts, and I am too interested in the intergovernmental, so I've never been on that. All these years I always defer to Trustee Yahiro, so if there is space on there, I would like to serve on that.
Trustee Holt.
I would like to continue with the Community Advisory Committee for SELPA. I'll yield the question for the intergovernmental group. It sounds like there's a lot of interest in that. I'm not sure. I would also like to serve on the arts education, but it depends on the dates and times. And former trustee Christina has asked me to find a replacement if we're going to have a lot of data.
Oh, I was going to say, I've always been on the adult, I've gone to all the adult education advisory committee, but if there's too many on that one, I've gone to it for the last many, many years, too. The adult education, I've been going to the meetings, but I never.
Okay. Ms. Trustee Serva?
How many do we have on the Fowler Valley Foundation?
So we currently only have two board members now that we have Vice President Holt. So we have Maria Rosa.
I'm still looking for somebody to serve on that, and I would love to serve on that until I find the right person.
Okay. So since we had enough people choose not to be on the intergovernmental, we only have three, and we have two or less on the other one. So we are good to go. The only one so we have everybody slated for at least on one of you on each one of them. So thank you very much.
Can you clarify the Intergovernmental Relations Committee?
Sure. I have down Trustee Shocker, Trustee Osmondson, and Trustee DeServa.
Because one of the default roles on that is usually the board president.
I was going to say,
and even listed here, I know last year Karen yielded that seat. But I think that needs to be asked of President Trustee Daniel Dodge, Jr.
He hasn't done his committee
yet. I don't mind doing that. I'd also like to join the Safety Committee and the Health Benefits Committee. All right.
So we will still have repeat who's on Intergovernmental Committee to make it clear.
So we have Trustee Shocker, Trustee Osmondson, and Trustee DeServa.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure we did have an out to us first.
All right, so after discussion from the board, can I have a motion?
Move it,
second.
I will now call for a vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? All right, so next up, approval of the agenda, 2.1, approve the agenda.
I move approval.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, next up, public comment on agenda-related